Welcome to this tutorial for composers who are interested in specifying consonant articulations like and vowel colorations such as on the flute, or for those who are interested in combining text with flute sounds. We won't be covering singing and playing today. Now, there is only one condition under which these sounds will be really distinct, and that is when the flutist is using air or aeolian sounds across the flute, like this. Now, you can speak them into the flute if you want that sort of muffled effect. One thing that works well in this inside position are vowel changes. Also, a clear indication of a position of the flute is very necessary. So if it's inside the flute or across the flute. Now, also, it's important to know if you're not setting your text or your phonemes in a recognizable language, use the international phonetic symbols. Now, if you want an articulated air sound colored by a consonant like this, or any combination of consonants like sh, or extended sibilants like s, there's a lot of freedom to choose, but common sense is your guideline. Now, if the sound produces a puff of air, which you can check on your hand like sh, p, p, then it will have carrying power. And you'll notice for the consonants that are located further back, like g, k, k, will not have the same carrying power. Now, nasal consonants do not produce a puff of air, but they can be carried by a vowel sound like this. So you see, in this airy context, any combination of consonants and vowels that you can actually say will work on the flute. It's also helpful for flutists to know if you want your phonemes to be voiceless, that is whispered, like, or voice, that is actually spoken. If you want them actually spoken or shouted with the resonance of the flute, be aware that there you'll actually have less resonance of the flute. It's kind of a trade-off because the vocal cords focus the air farther back in the throat, so there's less residual air up front that you can actually spit out and into the embouchure hole. I've been asked to shout and play at the same time, which I would love to do, but unfortunately it really doesn't work well on the flute because even if you're playing with an airy sound, with a loose embouchure, you can't open the mouth to let out the sound of the voice. So, nutshell, in an airy context, pretty much anything goes, but remember the trade-off, you add the voice, you'll lose some flute resonance. Now remember, I'm talking about text settings and phonemes, and not singing and playing. With singing and playing, you can add the voice and amplify the flute sound with overblown harmonics like this, where you get plenty of resonance, but there are no subtleties of consonants or vowels. And this brings us to the subject of using these sounds with a traditional sound, with a non-airy sound. Because when you add these techniques to a normal flute sound, they're much less effective. Sometimes I encounter the following. A composer wants to begin a normal sounding note, say a chord for woodwinds. And they'll write it with a very hard consonant, like a big scary capital T or even a pizzicato, and then wonder why that note doesn't cut through the texture. And I think that's because of a common misunderstanding about flutist tongues. They are flesh and blood like everyone's, and they're not mallets where the harder you hit it with something, the harder the higher partials are excited and the more sound you get. And you can experience this for yourself. If you yell the words, "Don't touch," the force of the attack is brought on by the buildup of pressure and the release of the tongue. And playing the flute articulation is exactly the same way. The flute sound is produced by releasing the tongue, and then with the shape of the mouth or with the lips, you excite the higher partials by directing the air, making it faster or slower or changing, as I said, the direction. So to be effective, this is one situation where I would say let the flutist produce the attack the best they can. You can indicate what you want, but don't expect the same effect that you'll get with a hard mallet or even with a single reed. Now, starting a normal flute sound with a nasal sound like m or n is impossible for obvious reasons because the air goes through the nose and not out the mouth. But you'd be surprised, I've been asked to do this. Now, one thing about vowels, one would think that indicating different vowel sounds for the flutist would be a great effect to change the tonal spectrum of a traditional flute sound. But sadly, it isn't that effective in normal playing. And especially in ensemble contexts, it really just tends to get lost. Flutists can and do change vowel shapes while playing, but the different spectra of different vowels are not as noticeable in playing to the extent they are as when you speak or when you sing. It's too bad we can't install little formant filter knobs in our mouths that we can crank up, but we compensate by making changes to the lips and the air pressure and the direction to change the color of the flute sound. So why is it not so effective? It's because the normal flute sound masks the subtleties of vowel changes. And I'll end this video by showing a sequence of sonograms that compares vowel changes. I'll do first one with my voice, then with airy flute sounds, and then with normal flute sounds. So here's the sequence of vowels with normal spoken voice, A, O, and E. A, O, E. Now here's the sequence with A, O, and E, and an airy flute sound. And now this sequence will show the same three vowels mixed with a normal flute sound. Now, just for experiment, I'll show a sequence of sounds with the flute that shows the different changing of colors, but not using the vowel sounds, but using more the angle of the air, the lip pressure, and the jaw position as well. And as you can see, you have a much greater shape to the spectral changes that you have than if you were only changing the vowel sounds. So I think this is one case where it might be good to let the flutist make the changes however they like. You can indicate the vowel sounds, but the changes will be made by the flutist in the way that flutists know how. That's it. If you have any questions, go to my blog. There are more tutorials and there's more information to be found about composing for the flute.